Hey yo, all my life people been telling me that I sound and look like a guy that's had his head punched in a lot. I guess they know how to spot a boxer when they see one. So anyways, it's my senior year and I decided that I needed to compete in the Bungle Beach to prove it.
So what you have to understand about Dan is he's never actually been a part of the boxing program.
Yeah, it's just something he does. Like, nobody ever asked him to do it. Nobody even wants him to do it, honestly.
Wait, you're not gonna put like friends under us, right? Because like we're not friends with Dan.
Definitely not.
Was there anything impressive about what he did?
Impressive? The dude trains pretty hard, but honestly, I don't know if he has the mental capacity to really understand pain. Just check out this video I took of him last week.
Look at this idiot. Dan, a little cold out, isn't it?
Just a little bit.
What kind of exercise do you do?
So I don't really know most of the fancy schmancy stuff. So I mostly just kind of run places and do push-ups and jump over things. You guys should come along for one of my training sessions.
Graduate now, you idiot!
In the end, out of his own safety, we couldn't let him box.
Yeah, the boxing coaches decided that I couldn't compete in the Bon Jovi band after all, because they decided that not only was I a safety hazard to myself and my opponents and the referees, I would also be a hazard to everybody in the immediate vicinity of the ring. It was beautiful. When I walked into the basement and I saw all those half-naked guys, I said, hey, that's me. Baby, let me be yours. You know I could be yours. Baby, let me be yours. I realized that in the end, the only reason I actually wanted to do the Benghazi beefs was that I could take my shirt off for it. I guess being a stripper in the Keenan Revue was my true calling after all. Baby, let me be your